Our previous episode of SpaceX in the News was 2 months ago, so it's time we catch up and do another. Let's begin. On the day our last sode released, August 8th, SpaceX posted on X that the next Starship and Super Heavy booster to fly is good to go. Also, the vehicles for Flight 6 have begun testing as they continue to wait for clearance from the FAA. Well, about a month and a half went by, and still no approval had come through the governing agency, despite an increasing amount of pressure from SpaceX for the agency to keep up. Leading SpaceX, and many with common sense to suspect this was likely the FAA's reason for then fining SpaceX $633,000 for violating their regulations during two missions in 2023. I know, convenient timing. Allegations SpaceX denies. This only further fired up Elon's rocket company to go to Congress, the public, and the media for backup. I received both the emails they sent out in September that included a PDF of a letter that they forwarded to both bodies of Congress. Ultimately, SpaceX accused the FAA, and specifically Biden's appointed administrator Mike Whitaker, of lying before Congress concerning these supposed violations, leading many to suspect this is just more lawfare being used against Elon via his companies for joining with the conservative right. Something Dems have a history of doing to their political enemies. Remember, when the left screeches, "Keep politics out of space," what they really mean is politics they don't agree with. By now, all honest people have come to an understanding that it's leftist politics that threaten not just space exploration, but the very freedoms that have gotten America this far. Which is why Elon has gone full dark MAGA.
"We will lead the world in space exploration. Thank you, Elon. We will lead the world in military, and we will reach Mars before the end of my term." We're going to win, and he's going to reach Mars by the end of our term, which is a big thing. Before China, before anybody, right? And my money's on that guy right there.
I think this election, I think it's the most important election of our lifetime.
Although SpaceX still hasn't received regulatory approval to launch TF5, word is it's possible they could, and so they're aiming for liftoff this Sunday the 13th at 7 a.m. Central Time. But even if the green light comes, scheduling is dynamic and likely to change. SpaceX has recently written on their website that because Flight 4 was such a success, you know, splashing the booster down within a half centimeter of the target, the company will attempt to catch TF5's booster with the tower so long as everything goes nominally. If automated health checks show non-nominal data prior to boost back burn shutdown, the vessel will change trajectory for a splashdown in the Gulf. The upper stage Starship will fly a similar trajectory as the previous flight test and make a splashdown in the Indian Ocean. And once again, a deorbit burn for re-entry is not required. And the big upgrade for this mission is to the heat shield. The thermal protection system has been replaced with newer gen tiles, a backup ablative layer, and additional protections between the flap structures. And to wrap it up, a really quick word on the Polaris Dawn mission. The Dragon launched on September 10th and completed SpaceX's first EVA, although it was more like a mostly extravehicular activity. But of course, the most impressive feature of the mission remains the chutes bra. After the capsule created sky skid marks, she popped drogues for stability and mains for survivability, dunking the crew in the ocean like a bobber fishing for krakens. But that's all for this one. Thanks for stopping by, and I'll see you again for Test Flight 5, whenever that may be. Until that time, Godspeed.